Hi, my name is Hamid. Excuse me. I'm a certified instructor at ASM Educational Center. Our website is www.asmed.com. Today I'm going to talk about multi-layer switch. So what does that mean? If you remember from last lab, we had a route on stick. That means we had the switches. We have VLAN 2 and VLAN 3. These guys can talk and these guys can talk. In order they talk, we create a router. We connect the router and we put a SOP interface. If you remember that, we say capture.1q2, 2 correspond to this VLAN. IP address 10.10.10.100, 255.255.255.0, that corresponds this default gateway. INT F00.3, in capture.1q3, 3 means VLAN 3, and 2020.100, which corresponds to this. So this wasn't route on stick. That means you have to use a switch and the router. Now, instead of using this technology, we have a new technology called multi-layer switch. That means instead of using a switch and a router, we're going to combine it and we're going to use one devices, okay? So I'm going to close these things and we're going to look at this right now. So we're going to do multi-layer switch on here. If you look at my notes, so this is multi-layer switch we're going to talk about today. What does that mean? Now that we have seen how the router and stick works, we can introduce layer 3 switches. In the router and stick topology, if we could bring the router inside the switch, in a sense, and that if we could give the switch, a switch is a layer 2 device, a capability of a router, layer 3. This is where layer 3 switch is going to be at work. Now there are three things you have to remember that. First thing you have to do, whenever you go to the switch, you have to make act like a router. So you have to say switch config T. We're going to see all of this IP routing, because that's a layer 2 is. You have to make a layer 3. Number 2 is that on layer 2 switches ports, I cannot give an IP address. In order to do that, you have to go to port. It's a no switch port. For example, you go to port config T INT F05, no switch port. Then you get some kind of IP address. IP address 192.168. That you have to type this. When you have no switch port, that means this point on this interface is going to act like a what? Like a router interface, okay? The last thing you have to do, you have to make sure give IP address of a default gateway to particular virtual interface, like INT VLAN 2, INT VLAN 10, INT VLAN 5. Now, if the switch needs to route using a virtual router, we need to be able to assign IP address to that virtual router. The virtual router inside the switch will be acting as a default gateway. This is done by creating virtual interface using command INT VLAN something, which is VLAN IDs. You can shut down or bring it up this side just for any other interface. So all you have to say VLAN 10, for example, name management, then you can say well INT VLAN 10, then you can give IP address. IP address like 11, like that and so on. This will act as a default gateway for all my switch, okay? So what are we going to do? We're going to go back to our original diagram that we had here. So let me show you this diagram we have here. I already have that. If I go back to here, I already created VLAN. Show VLAN brief. We see that VLAN 2, port 1 and 2 is. That's this PC. PC 1 connect to port 1 and PC 2 connect to port 2. And VLAN 3 is equal to EGR. That's port 4 and 5 is. Now if I go to PC1, if I ping it, I can see I can ping my what? 10.10.10.2 right here. If I go here, if I say IP config, I can see my IP is 2020.40 is, and I can ping 2020, I'm sorry, ping 20.20.20.5. So life is good. So right now they can talk to each other, okay? Now before the last line we had a router on stick. That means we put a trunk here and we put a router. Instead of that, we're gonna use what? Multi-layer switch. Right now PC1 cannot ping 20.20.20.4. So right now PC1 cannot ping what? This PC. Why is that? Because I have to make this device act like a router. That's what this class is. This is called multi-layer switches, okay? So back to my notes here shows you my switches. I created VLAN 2 name sales, VLAN 3 name EGR. I've done that. I integrate F0 that. all of that, I create all the assignment, then I say show VLAN brief. We have like, so far we have like here in my notes, okay? Now I can ping here, but I cannot ping the other side yet. That's what it shows in this picture. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna give SVI this act like a default gateway. So I'm gonna go to my switch right now. So I'm gonna say it as follows. Config T, INT VLAN. The VLAN has to match with this number. I cannot just assign two. It's gonna be two here, okay? Then you're gonna say what? IP address. Now this IP address is gonna be 10.10.10.100 with 255.255.255.0. It's very important to know that this IP address for VLAN 2, INT VLAN 2, act as what? Default gateway for what? For my PC. This is default gateway. And this is for my default gateway, okay? So that's that part. Then you're gonna say what? INT VLAN 3. Now why 3? Because that's what the VLAN 3 is right here. IP address 20.20.20.100 with 255.255.255.0. Okay? Now if I say show run, I go all the way down, I see the D is act as a what? A default gateway, okay? You can also say show IP INT brief. Oops, sorry about that. I can see these are my default gateway, okay? Right here, 10.10.10.100, that's for VLAN 2, and 20.20.100, that's for VLAN what, 3. All right, so that's what we did so far in my notes too, okay? Now, if I type in show IP run, look what happened. If I go to the switch, type in show IP route, I don't see nothing yet. Why is that? As I said before, why is that? Because you have to make this switch act like a router. So you have to say config T IP routing. So let's do that quickly. So I'm gonna go config T IP space routing. You have to turn it on to act like a what? Router. Now if I use up arrow key, show IP route, now I see both network 10.10.10.0 and 2020 is directly connected. You see, directly connected right here to VLAN 2 and what? VLAN 3, okay? Now, we have show IP route, we see that? This. Now let's see if we can ping it right now. I go to PC1. Before, I could not 2020.4 right here. Now let's see if I can ping right now. Okay, let's wait. All right, we can ping, that's very good. So that means I have connectivity from where to where. I have connectivity from here to here. Now let's say down the road you add another VLAN, another department, you create your port, assign the port, create VLAN what, 4, then you can say INT VLAN 4, IP address 3030.100 with 255.255.255.0, then everybody can talk, okay? Good job. So that's that part so far. Now I'm going to talk about something called routed ports. The routed port, that means in this diagram, you're going to give IP address. I'm going to connect to one port right here. I'm going to connect to another port. This is called routed port. So I'm going to go to, let's say, port 10, give IP address 192.168.1.50 with 255.255.0. And here on the router, we're going to give 192.168.1.1. So this is 150.1.1. So that's what we're going to do. This is port 10 is. So I'm going to open up the packet tracer. I'm going to bring this down a little bit so we can see better. Now I'm going to give it what? Click router, put 2811 router right here, connect a cable, straight through cable. You're going to go from F010 to what? F00, okay? And this one's going to be what? 192.168.1.50/24. And this one, which is F00, 192.168.1.1/24. Okay? That's what we're gonna talk about. This is 1.1, this is 1.50, okay? But in order to do that, you have to go to the switch config. You go to that port, INT F010, you have to say no switch port. then you have to say IP address 192.168.50. You have to do that. Now let's try it. So I'm going to go to switch. Now watch this. Config to int f/10. Now let's see if I don't have no switch for IP address 192.168.1.50 with 255.255.255.0. See, it does not work. Why is that? Because you have to say what? No space switchboard. No space switchboard, that means make this interface act like a router. Act like a, you have to go IPS. Now I push up arrow key, now you take it, okay? Then you gotta say, you can say no SHA-2, no need that. That's that part. Let's save it. Now go to router 1. I'm gonna say no here. Enable config t host name r1 no ip dash domain dash lookup. Again, why we type this? So in case you type in CCNA, see that it doesn't waste my time, it doesn't look up for DNS. That's what we do. If I say show ip int brief, show ip int brief, I see that I have this guy right here, and we say config t int f00 no shot. Now I want to give IP address what? According to the diagram, 192.168.1. Oops, sorry. IP address 192.168.1.1 with 255.255.255.0. That's this IP address right here. That's this guy right here. Control Z, show IP ante brief. Okay, that's up. Now let's see if I can ping my what? This guy. Ping 192.168.1.50. Sorry about that. Apologize. So I've connectivity between these two guys, okay? So that's good. Everything so far so good, okay? Again, what is that called? This is called what? This port is called routed port. Don't forget that. This port is called what? Routed port. Again, the key is you have to go under interface. You have to say no switchboard, then IP address, okay? Then I can what? Ping. I give IP address router. So life is good right now, okay? Now, from the switch, I can ping that. Let's go to switch, test it again. I'm going to ping 192.168.1.1. I'm right here, I'm pinging this guy. So life is good right now, okay? Now if I say show IP route, see, I have a two network. Network 10, this is guy. Network what? 20, that's this guy. And network what? 192.168. That. So life is good, okay? Now, if you go to one of the PC, try to ping this IP address. You see that it's not gonna what? Work. Now if I go to PC1, let's see if I can ping this guy. Ping 192.168.1.1.1. See, I'm right here, I cannot ping this guy. Why is that? Because it comes, this guy has to come back. It doesn't know how to come back. Why? Because it does not have a route back. So it doesn't, this router does not know how to get router 10 and what, router 20. So one way to solve the problem is a static route or dynamic routing. But we're gonna do static route. So if I go to router 1, look at this router 1. Show IP INT brief. See, router 1 has only this network. Now when I say show IP route, see, router 1 only see network that. It does not see network 10 and 20. So in order to do that, we have to do a static route. That's what we say in my notes right now here in our notes. The ping test failed. Why? Because remember that we need to have bi-directional communication. The layer 3 switches knows about the router prefix and can route traffic out to a router. However, the router does not know what traffic is originated from. It doesn't know about network 10 and 20. That's what. On the router, when I say show IP route, see only what? This guy. It does not see network 10 and 20. So in order to do that, we can do a static route. So I go to my router right now. So I'm going to say what? Config t IP routes, remember that? You gotta use a question mark. I need destination. What network I wanna go? Network 10. So 10.10.10.0, question mark. I need destination mask, which is what? 255.255.255.0, question mark. Now I gotta need the next interface. I'm right here, I wanna go here, so it will be what? This IP address. So I'm going to say 192.168.1.50. Same to operator key, instead of network 10, I'm going to put network what? 20. Okay, then I'll go to router 1, show IP route. Let's see if we have the, see now router 1, it knows how to go network 10 and network 20. S means what? Static route, which we've done that before, okay? Now, if you need a refresher, make sure you go check that. Now, if I say show run, you see that right here. I have the, this is my IP address right here. And these are static IP route, question mark. This is destination, question mark. Destination mask, and this is my next hop is because I'm right here, that's next hop. Same thing, IP route, 2020, that 255.255, and the next hop, okay? Now, if I go to PC1, I should be able to ping that one. So that's good. So what does that mean? That means you have a department, continue multi-layer switch, connect to the router, and this router can connect to the what? ISP and stuff like that. You can put a NAT, you can put firewall, then as long as I can ping here from there, then rest, you can go to internet. So again, this summarizes my notes for multi-layer switches, okay? Again, if you need any help or anything like that, we offer all of these in our website. Let me show you that. If you go to our website, asmed.com, under here, blocks, we have a CCNA, CCNP, CompTIA, so on, like that. And also, we have a bunch of what? Snapchat, YouTube, Google+, Pinterest, Instagram. Please check all of it, especially YouTube. When you go to YouTube, you can see like that. But when you go to blocks, CCNA, everything that I mentioned that, excuse me, under our blog right here, this is CCNA certification, VLAN configuration. When you go click here, not only you see the material which we talk, I'm gonna show you all step by step, then at the end of that, we're gonna show you a video, exactly what we speak. So I hope this was helpful. If you have a question or comment, it's our phone number 301-984-7400, or you can contact us and let us know. Thank you. Make sure you subscribe, and thanks so much for your time. Bye-bye.